Hi, it's Kiffin LeBates here, and today I thought I'd talk a bit about non-fungible tokens, because I got asked a question about those tokens, namely, is it possible for them to have multiple owners? So I think we'll start off with a quick look at what fungibility and therefore what non-fungible means. So at the one end of the spectrum, you have things that are totally fungible, and that would include things such as a gold, because one atom of gold is identical to another. And that means that if someone gives you a gram of gold and then you give them a gram of gold back, it doesn't have to be the same nugget that you give them, because gold is gold. However, at the other extreme, you have something like a Picasso painting. There'll be one of them. And if you lend someone that picture, if you happen to be A, fortunate enough to own such a valuable painting, and B, foolhardy enough to lend it out, then at the end of the lending period you expect to get exactly the same painting back, not another Picasso or a painting by Mondrian or something like that. So unique pieces of art are examples of something that is completely non-fungible. And then most things kind of fall in the middle. For example, trees. If you're looking at pine trees, one pine tree is very much like another one, especially if you're chopping them down and turning them into firewood. So when it comes to firewood, pine trees are fungible. However, there may be a specific tree that you're very fond of or that has historic significance, in which case that particular tree will be non-fungible. It's a unique entity, it may be special to you, maybe to other people it won't be. You know, here's a tree in my back garden, it's special to me, to you guys it's just yet another pine tree in the Finnish forests. So that also introduces the fact that fungibility is a relative thing. Something that is fungible to one person may be non-fungible to another. And we can look at things, for example, like cash or bitcoins. A $100 bill or a $1 bill is pretty much like the next one. So cash is fungible, except if you happen to receive stolen banknotes, because they all have serial numbers on them, which reduce their fungibility. And this is the same case with Bitcoin. One Bitcoin is pretty much like another one, unless it comes from an address that is known to have been involved in a theft, in which case you may find that you can't offload those Bitcoins so easily. So, you know, it's slightly more complicated than may first seem. And I have to be careful walking down the hill here because it's very icy. Right, so non-fungible tokens. Well, the idea of non-fungible tokens is to be able to create a digital entity on a blockchain that has a defined owner. And the classic example of this is CryptoKitties. Each CryptoKitty is represented by a token on the Ethereum blockchain, and it has an owner, and can't just willy-nilly exchange one CryptoKitty for another one. Each one is unique. So you can trade them, but and you can swap them if you so choose, but because they're unique, they are effectively non-fungible. And so the question I was asked is it possible to have fractional ownership of a non-fungible token? And the answer there is, on the surface level, no, because you can't split up a non-fungible token. One of the things about non-fungible items is that they are entities in and of themselves. So if you go back to the Picasso picture, nobody's going to want, well, actually some people would want half a Picasso, but really you want to keep it as a unit. You don't want to go and cut up a Picasso painting into lots of little pieces. It'll change the nature of the entity, and in fact you'll probably reduce the overall value of the item. So non-fungible items are generally units. So in that case, given that it's a unit, how can you have fractional ownership? Well, you can have fractional ownership of physical objects in the real world. For example, my wife and I jointly own our house. And because we're both paying half the mortgage, then it kind of means that she owns half and I own half. So is it possible to carry this kind of fractional ownership over into the blockchain world? And the answer is actually yes. And the way you do it is with multi-signature accounts. So each token, each non-fungible token on the blockchain has an owner. There will be an account or an address associated with the ownership. Effectively, that's what the blockchain is doing. It's a ledger of items, tokens, or cryptocurrency and who owns them at this particular moment in time. And when you have an address, you have a private key that allows you to sign the transfer of the ownership of the item over to somebody else. So this is where fractional ownership can come in, which is you can kind of get around the unit nature of a non-fungible token by allowing multiple people to own it through multi-sig addresses. If you have an account or an address that is registered as owning the non-fungible token, if it's a multi-signature account, then that means that several signatures are required to transfer it. So, for example, you might have a 4 of 5 account, which means there are 5 private keys and at least 4 of them have to sign the transfer transaction in order to transfer the token from that account to a new account. And that kind of gives you a way of having fractional ownership. For example, if you had a 2 of 2 multi-sig account, that means there are 2 private keys, 2 people could each have one of those keys, and then in a sense they both own the token together because both of them have to agree to relinquish ownership by signing with their private key before a transaction would become valid. So it's not quite the same as having for example, a Bitcoin and actually having fractions of that Bitcoin all owned by different people and them having control over those particular fractions. When you have something that's a unit, everybody has to agree that now is the time to transfer it. So that's kind of a quick summary of what non-fungible tokens are and how you can have a sense of fractional ownership of them. I hope you found that interesting and see you in the next video soon. Bye for now.